Serena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Cundy.
Everybody, I'm laughing because you really don't know what goes on. Back of that thing when I come out there, there are two steps. I just tripped up them, and as the door opened, I was almost right down there. Welcome to Tattletales. It's nice to have you all with us. We have three great celebrity couples. You're going to meet them now. On my left, winning money for the blue section today, Mr. Steve Forrest and his wife, Chris. Oh, you should have seen me trying to get out here. That was funny. How are you?
Fine.
Ready to go?
Ready to go.
Okay, and
ready
SWAT
to go
is
and
rolling
win
along.
For the blue.
Okay, win for the blue, they will. Winning money today for the banana section, the yellow section, Mr. Gene Rayburn and his lovely wife, Helen.
Yeah.
Hello, darling.
Hello, darling.
All right, Helen, Gene, this
yes.
is it, right, gang?
This is it, right.
Here
is
you
it?
Go.
Well, we got the bananas on our side now, and I think it's going to work.
I think it's going to work,
right.
too. And working for the red section today, winning a lot of money for them, I am sure, Nancy Sinatra and her husband, Hugh Lambert. If you are ready, ladies and gentlemen, I am ready. The first question, Hugh, Nancy, are you ready?
Ready.
I
yes.
should be sure that you're all, you can hear me and you're all set back there, Nancy. Okay, here we go. First question worth $150. Ladies, sometimes when a woman is really in a huff, she'll lock her husband out of the room or lock herself in the room. How many times have you been so angry that you have locked a door between yourself and your husband? Once, more than once, or never? Uh-huh. Sometimes when a woman is really in a huff, she'll lock her husband out of the room or lock herself in the room. How many times have you been so angry that you've locked the door between yourself and your husband? Once, more than once, or never? Okay, that's the question, girls. Think about it. We're coming back for your answer in just a second. Here we go. We'll start with you, Steve. What's Chris going to say to that? Is she a door locker?
She's not a door locker.
Uh-huh.
No, she's not. That's a very, that requires a lot of memory on. I've got to go through the memory bank of a long time and
yes.
try to remember it.
How long have you been married, Steve?
In anger, you mean. Or in whatever, you know.
No,
because
how long have you been married just in normally?
No. Forever.
Oh, I see.
Always,
okay.
You know, same lady, always. Yeah, you're talking about somebody who's disappointed or mad or something like that.
Yeah, really angry.
I don't think she's going to say never.
She's going to say never.
She's going to say never.
She maybe has slammed a door, but...
Yes.
But
thrown a little.
Thrown a little.
Little ashtray. Little plate.
Really? Has she ever hit you with an ashtray or a plate?
No.
Does she ever tie you down and whip you?
That's your game.
Oh, I see.
Ours is the machine, you know.
Oh, I see. Oh, yes.
See how he does? Gene tries to get that match game
no,
stuff
I,
in.
I think she's going to say never.
She's going to say never.
She's got to tell the truth.
Let's bring her on and
she's
find
out.
She's
a darling.
Chris, have you ever gone through the door, slammed it, locked it? Have you ever done that? Have you done it once or more than once or never?
Bert, my memory on this one is very good.
Yes.
And I have never.
That's what the man said. You're absolutely right, love, and that's very sweet. Have you ever, let me just take a wild guess here. Have you ever thrown anything at Steve or anything like that?
Oh, that's not a fair question.
I'm sorry. You're
Why
right. It's not?
Not
fair. You're absolutely right. You have a share of the pot. Gene, what's Helen going to say?
Well, you know, we've been married so long, it might have happened and I've forgotten.
Yes.
But,
yes.
And while my wife, as any of our personal friends know, is capable of enormous hostility.
Yes. All right.
But she has never thrown anything.
No, that's not the question.
What is the question?
The question is... Has she ever gone through a door and locked it? Are these too tough for you, Gene?
Yes. Well, without a blanket, it's hard for me.
Has she ever blanked a door between
no,
you?
No, never.
She's never done it?
No.
Okay, you're going to go with never.
There
choice,
are other ways.
Your choices are once, more than once, or never. And you're going to say never.
Oh, yeah, no contest.
Bring Helen on. Helen, have you ever locked that door between yourself and Gene? Have you done it once, more than once, or never?
There's been a lot of door slamming, but I've never locked it.
That's what he said.
You're right, what he said.
Absolutely right. Very well done. A lot of door slamming, but no locking?
Well, when you slam the door real hard, that gets rid of your unresolved hostilities,
that's exactly
you see.
That's
right.
True.
Right.
So you don't have to lock it. That'd be kind of anticlimactic.
And I've only done that 455,000 times.
Yes, all right. Well, you're absolutely right this time, too. Hugh, what's Nancy going to say?
It's pretty much the same thing. Like the other two guys, some door slamming, an occasional door closing, but no door locking.
But never. No door locking. No. Okay, let's bring Nancy on. Nancy, what is the answer? Have you ever locked that door between you and Hugh? Have you done it once, more than once, or never?
Never.
That's what he said.
Never.
Hey, gang, you're starting off awfully well. Everybody's right. We split the opening pot three ways. We'll come back in a moment and split all the rest of them. See you after this message.
Introducing the future.
Question number two coming up. This one is worth $150 as well. If you are ready, ladies, here it is. A very personable lady moves next door to you. She invites you over for a get acquainted cocktails party. No, for get acquainted cocktails. Before you go, you learn that some years ago, she committed a rather famous axe murder and was acquitted because she was judged legally insane at the time. Which of you would be more eager to go to her cocktail party, you or your husband?
What?
Let me say that again, only better. A very personable lady moves next door to you. She invites you over for get acquainted cocktails. Before you go, you learn that some years ago, she had committed a rather famous axe murder and was acquitted because she was judged legally insane at the time. Which of you would be more eager to go to her cocktail party, you or your husband? Think about it, ladies.
It got worse
the second
time.
This is the music. We'll come back for your answers in a moment. There they go. Oh, the poor dears. What are they going to do with this question? Gene, how is Helen going to answer this?
I'm you sure Vincent Price started this way?
Yes, absolutely.
Lizzie Borden took an axe and gave her husband 40 whacks. When the job was neatly done, gave her mother 41. I didn't. None of you remember Lizzie Borden.
Which one of you would be more eager? I guess out of curiosity, really, to see.
Well, I mean, I don't think either one of us would want to go to such a macabre thing. But
really?
If we have to, I mean, we got to say one or the other. We can't say neither one, can we?
No, the choice is which of you would
which
be
of
more
us?
Eager.
Well, I think she would. I think I'd chicken out and brave Helen would go there.
Really?
I'm gonna get my head just split open down the middle there. I got one part of my head.
But now you remember the lady was judged legally insane at that time.
I don't give a damn what she's gonna say. I'm saying I'm not going to that party, and you can't make me go to that party.
You have to go to that party.
No.
Yes, you do.
I'm sending my wife.
You have to go to that party,
Gene. I'm not going, she's going.
All right, you'll say that Helen will be more eager to go. Let's bring her on. Helen, which of you would be more eager to go to this lady's cocktail party?
That's what he said.
You're right.
You almost caught me out of it, you weirdos.
The way you were saying me reminded me of Psycho. Me, 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 me. Remember that?
She's seen all those movies.
You have, huh? You're absolutely right, Helen. Would you find that really interesting? I would. I
think. Sure.
Yeah.
I'd be fascinated.
I married a weirdo.
Never mind. But she's right. Hugh, what's Nancy going to say?
I think she'll say that I would be more anxious to go. I would be.
You would?
Oh, yeah, I'd be very curious.
I think it would be fascinating,
huh?
Okay, you will say that she will say you are the one.
Yeah.
Let's bring her on. Nancy, between you and Hugh, That's not easy to say. Mm-hmm. Between you and Hugh, who... Between you and Hugh, who would be more...
To go to
the party with this lady.
Well, if she axed us over, I'd be the one to want to go.
That's not what he said. But that was a very clever pun.
Oh, gee, thanks.
I thought that was terrific.
I really couldn't have given you a true answer on that. I'm awful sorry.
He thought he would be more likely, more eager to go to see that lady.
Oh, I don't think so. I would like to know what went on.
Sorry about that. Steve, what's Chris going to say?
Well, I think that she knows that I'm always observing, you know, looking at people. I go out. I even go to the zoo twice a year to see the orangutans. The most spontaneous behavior in the world is an orangutan, you know.
That's true.
And people like that would interest me. I think she's going to say that I would be the one most eager to go.
Yeah. Someone who's interested in monkey business.
I'd bet money on it.
Probably would be the guy to get over there. Okay. The blue section agrees. Let's bring on Chris, see if she does. Chris, between you and Steve, who would be more eager to go next door and see this ex-axe murderess?
Well, Bert, I don't really think either of us would be, but if I have to choose, it certainly wouldn't be me.
That's what the man said. You are right. Chris and Steve, Helen and Gene split the pot at halftime. We'll change places, fellas. If you will, step to the rear. We'll bring the ladies out front. While we're changing places, we'll break away for these messages. Second half coming up. Please come back now.
Stay tuned to get this luxurious designer.
That's 1-800-329-5763. Call now.
Woo-hoo-hoo. Here we go. What question? We have just changed places. That's where we are. Things are mad here when you're gone. I wish you could see what goes on. If you are ready, fellas, this is it. By the way, Gene, you and Steve are tied with 125 apiece, and Hugh, you got to do some catching up. Here we go.
All right.
Many men these days, whether rightly or wrongly, are concerned about their status in society. Which of the following
That's
do you think
status.
Gives a man more status or status?
Okay.
His job, his material possessions, or his friends? Not an easy one. Many men these days, whether rightly or wrongly, we're not passing judgment, we're just saying, which do you think? Many men are concerned about their status in society. Which of the following do you think gives a man more status? His job, his material possessions, or his friends? Okay, think about that. Fellas, we'll come back and see how you feel about this heavy one. There they go. Nancy, we'll start with you.
Oh, thanks.
What do you think? Now, we're not talking about you people, really. We're talking in general.
Well, but that's hard to do in general.
Yeah, it is.
Have to be a little bit closer to home, I think. Well, being in the ranks of the unemployed, I would think that the job then would have nothing to do with it. Now, I have to remember, I have to be personal because I can't speak for anybody else.
Right.
I would have to say friends, I think.
His friends.
What other people think of you. Yeah, I think.
Uh-huh. Okay, that would give the man, you think you will say, more status. What his friends think about
you. Give me the middle one again.
They were his job, his material possessions, his friends.
Oh, that's a tough one for a man, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Very hard. That's right. You're answering for Hugh.
For Hugh, okay.
Which would he think would give a man more status?
My Marinata section over there. From the men. Material things.
They're yelling out material possessions and jobs. So.
It's your money.
Friends.
Friends has it.
Okay, you're going to say are his friends. Let's bring on Hugh and see what he says. Hugh, it's a tough choice now. Which of the following do you think gives a man more status? His job, his material possessions, or his friends?
I think his job.
It's a tough one. That's not what Nancy said. But she sure thought about it.
She said friends, right?
I couldn't do that, lover, because you don't have a job, and in my opinion, you are the tops.
She did say that first, and then she settled for friends.
Yeah,
and there
right.
you are. Sorry, Hugh.
Okay.
Okay, Chris, how about Steve? How does he feel about it?
Well, that's hard. I think I'd have to say his work, so it would be his job.
You think that was the thing that... Okay. All right, he'll say his job. Let's bring him on. Steve, of the following, which do you think gives a man more status? His job, his material possessions, or his friends?
I take it you want a fast answer.
No, not necessarily.
No, because I could do hours on this one.
Well, give us your answer first, and then you can qualify.
Not for nothing, I'm a Baptist preacher's kid, you know. No, I think it is material things.
His material possessions. No, that's not what Chris said. That's interesting. See? All these answers apply. It's just a question of which one you think is more.
You didn't ask us what.
I said your work. I thought it would be your work.
She said the job.
Your job.
She said his job.
Yeah.
Okay. That was a tough one.
That's important, too.
Well, you didn't ask didn't ask what it ought to be.
No, I did not. I said whether rightly or wrongly, these days, many men are concerned about their status in society. We made it general, so we didn't list all of them. No, these are three goodies, though, I think.
We can't fight over that one.
No, you can't.
That's
really
a near
at all.
One.
Okay, nobody's gotten it right yet, Steve, either. So, Helen, what's Gene going to say?
I think Gene will probably go along with the sociological answer, and I do believe that Audrey and territorial possession and all of that sort of thing, I think man's material possessions people...
All right.
No,
she knows what she wants to say, so let's bring her in.
I really do believe that.
Okay. Gene, admittedly, it's a tough question, and no one has gotten it right yet.
I know this rich, friendly, steady-working guy.
Now, which of the following do you think gives a man more status? His job, his material possessions, or his friends?
Now, let me understand. This is a personal opinion you want from me. This is not what I think average America thinks.
It says, which of... Do you think... Yes, I want your personal opinion on a general question, really. Many men these days, whether rightly or wrongly, are concerned about their status. That's the way we set it up. So, which of the following do you think gives a man, not you, not anyone personally, but gives a man more status?
I think the measure of a man is determined by the number of friends he has.
That's not what Alan said. But don't feel bad, because no one got it right. You all had various answers, and they're all equally viable answers. I'm sorry, but
what did the ding-a-ling say? What did she say?
I said you would go along with the sociological answer. You're
going
to get such a hit after the show.
I can hardly wait.
We'll come back in a moment. Since no one got that one right, we'll add it over to our next question. Will then be worth $450. And we'll come back and play for that in just a minute. You come back now.
Is your AC busted? Computer...
Settle down! One at a time. Who's first? Thank you. Next. Good. Try to make it funnier. A for effort.
See who passed the whammy auditions on Press Your Luck. Today at 4, only on Buzzer.
Now it works.
Anybody can win the game, folks, because this question is worth $450, and this is fun. Here we go. Fellas, if you're ready, this is it. Men.
Let's go.
Before you were married, did you mostly date girls that were more pretty than smart or more smart than pretty? That's the question for 450 big ones. Before you were married, did you mostly date girls that were more pretty than smart or more smart than pretty? And think about that one. We'll come back for the big answers in just a second. There they go. Nancy, we'll start with you and Hugh. Did he date girls that were more pretty than smart or more smart than pretty?
More smart than pretty.
You're going to say more smart than pretty. Okay. She's thought about it, and here he comes. Hugh.
Yeah.
Before you were married, did you mostly date girls that were more pretty than smart or more smart than pretty?
More pretty.
Oh. Not what the lady said. However, we do learn little things along the way, don't we?
Yeah.
Sorry about that, Hugh.
Not from the ones I saw.
That's what I thought you'd say.
Chris, how about Steve? What's he going to say?
I think he's going to say more smart than pretty.
Really? Interesting how the women want to believe that, isn't it? Okay, you'll say more smart than pretty. Let's bring Steve on. Steve, before you were married to Chris, did you date girls that were more pretty than smart or more smart than pretty?
This is a troublemaker.
Mm-hmm. Well,
this is a real troublemaker. But they were more smart than pretty.
And then I managed to get both.
Pandemonium is breaking out here, Steve. That's the first time I remember the blue section acting like the banana section. All right.
That's great.
You're
and
absolutely
then I got
right,
lucky
Steve.
And got both.
Helen, how about Gene?
Gene dated girls that were prettier than smarter because he married the smartest one.
Don't you believe it? You're pretty, my dear. Let's bring on Gene and see if he agrees with you. Gene, which was it before you married Helen? Did you date girls who were more pretty than smart or more smart than pretty?
Would you explain what a date is? So long ago.
Yes.
Dating.
You remember that?
Yeah.
Yes.
I think I preferred the animals. I think I preferred the pretty ones.
That's what the lady said. You are right. We got there. That means Gene and Helen, Chris and Steve, split that pot in half. There it is. Hey, time is up. We have a tie. The yellow section and the blue section. We'll come back in just a second. Let you know how much they tied for after this message for you. See you in a second.
I've never seen a pillow that didn't...
From Copperfit.
We had a tie. The banana section and the blue section with Helen and Gene, Chris and Steve won $350. We had $1,000. They will divide $1,700 between them. Thank you all for coming. You and Nancy, Helen and Gene, and Chris and Steve, you were sensational. Thank you. And so were you. Please tune us in next time, won't you, on Tattletales. Bert Convy saying goodbye, everybody.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.